Hello everyone and welcome to this quick video on my soft selection. My name is Omar and we're going to take a look at the soft selection options in your move, rotate, and scale tools and then compare them to the more traditional soft modification tool. Now this option is available in Maya 2008 extension 2 or higher. So I've got a simple torus here, polygon torus. Alright, so I'll just grab a vertex here and move it around. Alright, this is fairly basic but we can do better. So to access the smooth option, there's a couple of ways. One of the most straightforward ways is just double click on your move tool, for example. That would bring up your move tool options, which you can turn on and off using the tool options box over here. Now you can scroll down a bit and you'll find your soft selection panel. All right, so we'll enable that. And instantly you'll see this coloring on a whole bunch of vertices around your selection. Okay, so if you click anywhere else, you also get that soft selection coloring. Now, as it implies, the lighter the color, the more of an effect your tool is going to have. So let's try it out. All right. So with this tool, you can quickly edit a whole bunch of vertices without having to calculate it yourself or manually try to figure out how to make it look smooth. All right. Now you can edit the falloff radius over here, and that will decrease how much the radius is of that effect. A quick way to do it is also using the B button. So if you hold B and then left mouse click and drag, you're sort of controlling that falloff radius in the viewport itself. It's very similar to the brush control, if you've ever used a brush system in Maya. All right. Now you can also edit the falloff curve, and we're going to take a better look at that on a plane. So I'm just going to create a plane and increase its resolution here. Alright, so if I just select a vertex here and reduce that a little bit. Okay, now you can see that falloff curve right there. Okay, and it matches what you have set up here. Now this could also be linear, so you get this type of effect. So really you can also go in and have your own weird type of fall off curve. And if I go back and increase the resolution on this one, maybe make it 50, all right, you can really have some cool detail. You can add some cool detail to your scene without a lot of work. The elements in the background could really use the variation and the randomness. Gives it more organic feel. All right. So really quickly, with only like three vertices selected, we got this nice effect, and I can turn off my grid here. So you've got this nice modification to your model without a lot of work. All right, this can be used to dent cars, add more of an organic feel to any object you want. Okay, and it's great. Also great for terrains. So if I grab something like this here, it's really great for backgrounds. You can quickly create hills and sort of easily manipulate them. All right. Now the other option I want to talk about is the reflection option. Okay, I'll bring back my grid. Okay, so I'll turn off the soft select here for a minute. Reflection, so just enable it right there. And there we go. We've got reflection of whatever your tool is doing to the other side. Now the options are fairly straightforward. So you've got your X according to X or Y or Z axes. All right, so if I go with Z, it's gonna go to the other axis. All right, you go Y, picks up the bottom one. And this is, you can set this to be according to the world axes or to your actual object axes. So when you rotate around, you can still maintain that symmetry for the object. And the object doesn't have to be perfectly symmetrical. Maya can sometimes try to figure out how what vertices on this side correspond to the ones that you select on this side. Okay, it can try to do that. It might not work every time, but even if it's not perfect, it will try, and usually it works fine. But even then, I would try the soft selection. So even if it's not an exact set of vertices on the other side, doing it this way kind of eliminates having to select the exact vertices, because you know that you're really interested in an area rather than specific vertices. So I want that whole part to be dented inside, so the part on the other side will also be like that. This is great for modeling, for any symmetrical modeling really. If you got, if you've got characters, cars, any element that has that symmetrical feature, it's a great way to quickly do that and visualize what your final symmetrical model would look like. All right. You can also play with the settings here a little bit further. So let me show you what these ones do. Okay, imagine that you have a situation like this, right? We've got really nice smooth curve like that. A surface, sorry, like that. Now, if I grab one of these here and I try to move it, you'll notice that I'm taking the whole object with me. What if I just want that surface part? Well, you can change the fall off mode to surface. And that way, I'm not dragging on the other parts. I'm still maintaining that soft selection, okay? But I won't be dragging with the same effect on the other part. Let me drag something like here, yep. So that basically says that that soft effect is gonna run along the surface. All right, not in a 3D volume. So when you enable 3D volume, you're kind of picking everything in that fall off radius within 10 units, but surface is within 10 units along the surface, okay? So if you've got tight areas like that, this option can be helpful. All right, so let's take a look at the soft modification tool now. This tool has been there in Maya for a really long time. I don't even know what version, from way back then. But the difference it has to these other ones is that it's its own separate tool. It's not an option in your move or select tool, it's its own separate tool. So what this can do is it can create a node that would attach to your object that would maintain all the changes that you want to have. So if I just select here, you'll notice that it creates its own node. That little S there, that's the thing that controls the smooth manipulator. All right, so I can create as many as I want on that model. All right, and you can also delete it. So you can select one of them there and just delete it, and that effect will go. And if you look at your actual model, all right, you'll find those soft modification nodes right there in its history. And if you're happy with the way it looks like and you just want to have a model, go ahead and clear its history. And that will take care of these nodes. All right. But I want them there. I want to try something out. So with these soft modification tools, what you can do is you can later on manipulate them and edit them. Kind of gives you that freedom. You can edit their options also in your attributes editor. So you've got all the options that you've had in the other one. Okay, and I'm going to create something like that. Now, this is also great for animation, because now you can animate every single attribute in this node. All right, so I'll quickly try to create an animation here. So by just adding a couple of keyframes to these objects here, just moving them and scaling them, you can have some really cool animation effects that don't take a lot of time, no rigging, no bones involved, and you get a really nice animation there. All right, thank you, and See you next tutorial.